Welcome to Vynix Studio. Let's start making games. Hi and welcome. In this tutorial, we're going to see how to add a simple button in Unity. And then we'll see how to call a function when the button is pressed. To add a button, just click on the plus sign in the hierarchy, go to UI and button. If you double click on any element on the hierarchy, it will zoom to that element in the scene view. Now move the button to the place where you want it. So I'm going to move it to the center of the screen. And as you can see, I have a button. So let's see how it looks in the game view. So this is how it looks in the game view. The next thing, we'll see what the button has. The button also has a text component to it. If you're using older version of Unity, you will have a normal text, but in the new version of Unity, you only have Text Mesh Pro. We'll see about Text Mesh Pro a little later. In the button game object, there is an image component and a button component. The image component determines how the button looks in your scene. So for example, you can select any other sprite as a button. So if you select the knob as a button, the button looks like this. So you can also have custom game objects. For example, I have a character here. To use this character as a button sprite, it should be set to sprite 2D and UI. And click apply. Then go to the button. So you can even use this character as the button image. So this is my button now. So now we'll see how to call a function, when the button is pressed. So if you select the button game object and go to the button component, you can see there is an on click event. Now when you click plus sign here, you can see this on click event takes a game object and the function attached to the game object as input. So generally for all the UI things, we have an empty game object which is called scene manager, or you can name it however you want it. So in the scene manager, let's add a script called button press. Inside the button press script, you need to have a public function. This function button pressed is a public function, and when this function is called, a log is displayed on the console saying button pressed. So now let's go back to the button game object. Go to the onClick event and drag and drop the scene manager to your onClick game object. Now you should see the button press script and the button pressed function. So select the button press function. And now if you play the game, and go to the console window and press the button, the message is displayed. That's it. You have created a simple button. Now you know how to call a function when the button is pressed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.